वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे विल बी डूइंग द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर सीजन्स फ्रॉम इंग्लिश लिटरेचर रीडर. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड डिस्कस द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सीजन्स like rainy season, summer season, autumn season, winter season, right? So like in winter season the trees shed their leaves and there is a nip in the air. Nip in the air means a slight chill in the air, a feeling of cold as the first signs of winter begin to show. It's a time of harvesting and fruit gathering in most parts of the world. Now the golden rod is yellow. Golden rod means a plant with bright golden yellow flowers. So the golden rod is yellow because it is autumn season. The corn is turning brown, means about to ripen. The trees in apple orchards with fruit are bending down. The trees are full of fruits. While people in tropical countries, warm tropical countries, look forward to the cool winters. We long for cool winters, people of the warm countries. While in the hills and northern countries, people start preparing for the freezing and sometimes snowy winters. So they get ready for the snowy winters in the hills and the northern countries. Like every fence and every tree is as white as white can be. White is white due to the snow. And then spring returns once more with the coming of March and April. I have heard a mother bird singing in the rain, telling all her little ones spring has come again. And so the cycle of seasons goes on and on. So scientists explain the change of seasons in their own way. They say that seasons change because different parts of the earth receive different amounts of sunlight, and that is due to the tilt in the earth's axis. So when the north pole is tilted towards the sun, tilted means lean or move into a sloping position, the northern hemisphere is summer and the southern hemisphere is winter. Whereas when the southern hemisphere is summer, the northern hemisphere experiences winter season. So this is the explanation of the scientist. Okay, but the Greeks of olden days, they had a different story regarding the change of seasons. They used to tell stories with imaginary facts. Now here is a story of the Greeks made about the change of seasons. So what is the story? Like Persephone was the daughter of Zeus, the king of the gods, and Demeter, means Persephone's mother. Demeter had the power to make the earth yield plentiful crops of grain. Yield means produce plentiful crops of grain. She also had the power to leave the earth barren. So Demeter, she had the power to make the earth produce abundant crops of grain, and she also had the power to leave the earth barren. Barren land means not good enough to produce plants and crops. So Persephone was a beautiful girl with pink cheeks like apple blossom. She was very beautiful. She was fair with pink cheeks like apple blossoms and blue eyes like the blue of the sky on a sunny April morning. This is a comparison. She was a spring itself. She spent her days dancing and singing with her companions in the valleys and glens. Glens means narrow valley, making the earth joyous. So how did she spend her days? She spent her days dancing and singing with her companions in the valleys. Hades. Now who was Hades? Hades was the grim ruler of the underworld. Grim ruler means unpleasant, not good enough, of the underworld, the land of the dead. He was a lonely king with only shadows and ghosts for his companions. So who were his companions? Shadows and ghosts, because he was the ruler of the underworld. One day when Hades came up to earth, he saw Persephone and her companions bedecked with flowers. So when one day Hades came up to earth, what did he see? He saw Persephone and her companions decorated with flowers dancing in the woods. In woods means forests. In other words, we can say in the forests. So now, looking at Persephone, he was so impressed by her beauty that he carried her off to his kingdom in his chariot. But while he was doing so, the nymph of the stream, nymph means what? Spirits of nature who lives in the trees, water and other natural objects. So while he was carrying Persephone in his chariot to his kingdom, the nymph of the stream, means spirit of the water, recognized Persephone. Just as Hades plunged underground to reach his kingdom, Persephone took off her girdle. Girdle means a belt or sash or around the waist, and threw it far into the river. She hoped that her mother Demeter would find it and look for her. When Demeter discovered her loss, when Demeter discovered her found that her daughter was lost, she was so grief-stricken. Grief-stricken means deep sorrow, that she wandered sadly over the earth. She kept on wandering sadly. She became so sad that her daughter was lost over the earth, looking for her daughter. She neglected all of her duties. As she was the corn goddess and looked after the harvest, the crops failed. So she neglected her duty because she was searching her daughter. So as a result, what happened? The crops failed and the ground became parched and barren. Parched means dry. It seemed that the earth felt sorry for Demeter and mourned with her. Mourn means show sadness or sorrow. So the mother earth also felt sorry for Demeter on the loss of her daughter. So Demeter continued her search for Persephone till she came back to the island of Sicily where she lived. One day while passing by the stream, she happened to see the girdle of Persephone near the shore. So while she was searching for Persephone, she returned to the island of Sicily where she lived. So one day while passing by the stream, what did she see? She happened to see the girdle of Persephone near the shore. Then she heard the voice saying, "I am the nymph of the stream." Then a voice was heard, and it was saying that, "I am the nymph of the stream." That means spirit of the stream. "I came up from the underworld. There I have seen your daughter sitting beside King Hades." So the spirit was telling this to Demeter, that it had seen her daughter sitting beside King Hades. But though she is the queen, she seems unhappy. Demeter went to Zeus and asked him to get her daughter back. If Persephone came back to her, the earth would once again be fertile and prosperous. So hearing this, Demeter went to Zeus and asked him to get her daughter back. And if Persephone came back, then the earth would once again be fertile and prosperous. Zeus felt sorry for the mother and the grieving earth. He told Demeter that Persephone could return to her home for a part of the year. So when Demeter asked Zeus to bring her daughter back, Zeus told that Persephone could return to her home for a part of the year, for a few months. But she would have to spend the rest with her husband in the underworld. So during those months of the year when Persephone stays with her mother, Demeter is happy. So few months Persephone used to stay with her mother Demeter, and those months Demeter is happy. And in these months the trees are covered with blossoms, the birds sing, and the green earth seems to be full of joy. The presence of Persephone on earth brings spring and fine weather. But what happens when Persephone goes down to Hades? During those months Demeter is sad because her daughter used to return back to the underworld to stay with her husband Hades, who is also the ruler of the underworld. So when Persephone used to return back, Demeter becomes sad again. Therefore the earth too is sombre and full of sorrow. Sombre means depressed and full of sorrow. So seeing Demeter in sadness, Mother Earth also becomes depressed and full of sorrow. The trees shed their leaves and no flowers bloom. The seeds go to sleep in the bowels of the earth. Bowels of the earth means deep or innermost part of the earth. Nature seems to be full of grief at the absence of the beautiful young queen. Full of grief means full of sorrow. Why? At the absence of the beautiful young queen, that is Persephone, and looks forward to her arrival on earth. When Demeter will be happy and the earth verdant once more. So when again Demeter's daughter, that is Persephone, when again she comes to stay with her mother for few months, Demeter will be happy and the earth verdant once more. Verdant once more means to become fresh and green. So I hope you all have understood this chapter. It is a beautiful story regarding the change of seasons by the Greek. So children, if you have any doubt, please ask me in the live class. I will be explaining once more. So thank you children, have a great day.